One Piece references are hidden everywhere, but Attack on Titan has one that nobody noticed. Because if you skip to episode 41, you can see this kid wearing a straw hat that's clearly a Luffy Easter egg. And these antlers are a little weird because they either reference Chopper or are just a coincidence. And while that was easy to find, JoJo's Bizarre Adventures hid their reference a little too well. Skip to part 8 of the manga and you'll find this normal looking scene. Until you realize this image is full of One Piece merchandise, with toy versions of Chopper and Luffy. But we can't go further without talking about the most iconic One Piece reference. This is Gintama, a show known for making parodies of anime, and One Piece is no exception, with a scene showing Gintama dressed identically to Luffy. You also have this clip that's a copy of One Piece's intro, but the best reference is in episode 329, where you can see Gintama eating the wavy wavy fruit, giving him cooler hair. Now, Assassination Classroom is famous for referencing Naruto, but it turns out their One Piece Easter eggs are way better.
Gum gum! Slingshot!
And that's not the only subtle reference, because just look at this student identically copying Luffy's gear second pose. Though my favorite reference has got to be this kid getting caught playing the official One Piece video game on his Nintendo DS. And that brings us to Momoji from the anime Good Luck Girl, who took things too far by literally becoming Luffy. Even her name was changed to Momoji D. Luffy. So at what point does this turn into stealing? Well, Tower of God is an anime that stole from One Piece, but they did it so badly, nobody cares. See, this is Full Black, and he's supposed to be a master swordsman, but it's impossible to take this dude seriously when he looks like a Walmart version of Zoro. I mean, if you want to be a cool swordsman, at least be original. And this wasn't a problem for Dragon Ball Super, since they won the award for the most creative One Piece reference in episode 17. Yeah, Krillin's ringtone is One Piece's opening song. Now that alone is a crazy reference, but the story isn't over, because it turns out Krillin has the same voice actor as Luffy, Mayumi Tanaka, who became so popular for playing our pirate friend that every anime she's in references One Piece. If you're not a fan of the anime fairy tale, you probably never realized how many times One Piece snuck in. Like, this side character is literally a clone of Shanks. Fairy Tail gets even more shameless because they even snuck Luffy in. You can see him hidden in this crowd. Or if you skip to episode 205, you can see him looking into the sun. Now, I was wondering why Fairy Tail hadn't gotten sued yet, and after doing a bunch of research, it turns out One Piece's creator, Oda, is great friends with Fairy Tail's creator. But One Piece isn't only hidden in anime, because American shows and video games do it too. And the reference in The Simpsons is probably the best because not only do they have a Walmart version of Zoro, but he's standing next to other dope references like Naruto, Pokemon, and Attack on Titan too. Now, Teen Titans is a popular kids show, and even they couldn't resist sneaking in One Piece, with this scene showing the main character Robin dressed up as Luffy. He even has the iconic chest scar. And in the background, you got a boat that looks suspiciously like the Thousand Sunny. This show is about superheroes, but secretly, they just want to be pirates. And that brings us to Assassin's Creed 4, the OG pirate video game, where you can run into a ship called the Thriller Bark, which obviously references the biggest ship in One Piece. The cool thing is that this ship destroys other boats on the sea, just like the real Thriller Bark. Whoever made this must have been a huge fan. But the biggest One Piece fan works at DC Comics, because when the company released a comic book about the hero Aqualad, it was filled with One Piece Easter eggs. Like in this scene where Aqualad is at the beach, you can see Nami and Robin sitting next to him. They didn't even try to hide these two. I mean, Nami's signature tattoo is right in your face. Next, we have a panel with a store called the Frankie House, referencing Frankie's old hideout. Unfortunately, he didn't make an appearance, but it makes sense since Frankie doesn't exactly look human. And Usopp's the final straw hat, with him showing up through a sniper scope, which is a perfect fit for the Sniper King. But I can guarantee nobody knows that the most popular video game of all time references One Piece. I'm talking about World of Warcraft, which has a secret weapon called Akainu's Absolute Justice. obviously, it's named after Aka Inu, the leader of the Marines. But the weapon doesn't only reference his name. It also references Aka Inu's powers, since it has magma powers too. Warcraft really decided to pay homage to the most hated character in One Piece. Now let's take a look at My Little Pony, because even they referenced One Piece, sneaking in pony versions of Luffy, Sanji, and Zoro. Honestly, this is the first time I've seen Zoro and Sanji not try to fight each other. But I guess being a cute pony does that to you. Look, I know that One Piece isn't exactly made for kids, but there's tons of kids' shows that reference it. Like this scene in The Amazing World of Gumball, where the characters recreate an iconic One Piece reaction. Just look at their faces compared to Luffy's. They're the same. On top of that, the creator of Gumball revealed he's obsessed with anime. So if there wasn't a One Piece reference in the show, it just wouldn't feel right. And the kids show Craig of the Creek also decided to hop on the bandwagon, but probably in my favorite way. The first reference was in episode 49, where one guy found a cool toy of Luffy's ship, the Going Merry. The second reference is even better, because a character in one scene holds a book called Two Piece with a picture of a girl wearing Luffy's straw hat. I don't think I have to explain this one. And the same goes for the Easter egg in a manga called Food Wars, because the creator snuck Nami into the series alongside popular girls from every popular manga. This page is really like 7 Easter eggs in one. But let's talk about the cutest One Piece reference on this list. This is an anime called IMOTO, and there's a character in it that's absolutely obsessed with One Piece, which is why she's constantly seen carrying around a small chopper plushie. You gotta love the fact that even other anime characters are fans of One Piece. Pokemon Go was one of the biggest apps in history because everyone was playing it, including the creator of One Piece, who admitted that he loves the game. The developers must have heard about this because they released a special Pikachu wearing a straw hat. This thing is super exclusive, so only the hardcore One Piece fans unlocked it. And the same hardcore fans went a little crazy trying to cancel Sonic the Hedgehog for copying One Piece. See, it all started with this One Piece book cover. It's nothing special, just your average manga cover. But the people in charge of the Sonic comics loved it, because they released a comic book with the exact same cover, but just Sonic-fied. They thought they'd get away with it, but fans called them out immediately. Now, I don't get it. Coming up, we have anime actually stealing from One Piece, but this is the time fans choose to get mad? Have you ever wondered what Sanji would do if he wasn't a pirate? Well, apparently the animators of this show did, because they created a food truck owner that looks exactly like Sanji. I guess owning a food truck would be easier than feeding Luffy. But let's talk about when Dr. Stone, the smartest anime, referenced One Piece. See, when someone asked this dude about humanity's greatest accomplishments, the first thing he mentioned was a monkey wearing a straw hat. And if you don't know anything about One Piece, you know it's about a monkey dude who wears a straw hat. So basically, this guy's saying One Piece is one of humanity's greatest achievements. Honestly, who can blame him? I think everyone should know about One Piece, because it literally brings people together. I mean, there's one One Piece reference that saved another anime's life. See, in the anime Haikyuu, this kid had to travel across the globe and ended up in a strange town with no friends. That is, until he realized he had the ultimate conversation starter, a love of One Piece. After learning this new power, he actually made friends and lived happily ever after. Dang, this man's social life was saved by anime. But let's go back to the Gintama anime, because it has way too many One Piece references for only one spot on this list. Sometimes the references are low-key, like this guy wearing Chopper's iconic hat, or that one time Gintama wanted to find a legendary treasure called the One Park. But other times, the references go too far. Like when the characters created the hit movie, Dragon and Bleep Piece. As you can probably guess, this is just a ripoff of several anime. If it wasn't obvious enough, they decided to give the main character some of Luffy's moves. On top of that, they also took Crocodile from One Piece and inserted him into the movie. Yeah, that's insane. But what's more insane is the fact that later on in the show, Gintama stole even more from One Piece. It happens in episode 329, where the main character declares that his dream is to become the Samurai King and become super rich. That's when he forms a crew and decides to go through a 2-year time skip, exactly like the Straw Hat Pirates. Unfortunately, the animators realized they were getting a little too direct with the references and cut things short before they stole the entire plot of One Piece. Netflix is about to release the live action of Scott Pilgrim, a famous comic book series. And as it turns out, the original comics have an iconic One Piece reference. You see, the main character's apartment is full of pop culture references. And the best one is this picture featuring the Straw Hat's Jolly Roger. At the end of the day, everything leads back to One Piece. Now we have to talk about the show's biggest reference ever. Back in 2014, One Piece released a special chapter honoring Naruto since its last chapter was coming out. The author of Naruto was so pleased that he had to return the favor, and the way he did it was amazing. Cause he drew the Straw Hat logo on Naruto's forehead. Honestly, it's pretty wholesome seeing two legendary series respect each other. But none of these One Piece Easter eggs are as ruthless as the anime Inuyashiki. See, this guy right here murdered this girl's entire family, and right before he left, he asked her this question.
Manga. Donna manga yume? One Piece? Usso, maji? Dare ga ichiban suki?
Yo, this guy is a psycho. But at the same time, he likes One Piece. So how bad can he really be? By the way, we're looking for a new scriptwriter. If you're at least 18 years old, think you're great at writing, and love anime, check out the description for a sign-up form. We pay well, and we need help.